So hello guys, welcome back to channel Get to Byte. In the last video we started with the RTC3231 IC interfacing it via our host microcontroller totally in embedded C code. We understand its key features, its pinout, its I2C bus flow that is used for configuring it and for interfacing it to our microcontroller. Now in this video we are going to understand its important things from the datasheet about its memory registers and how exactly those memory registers contain and how to access them. So now let's move forward. So RTC3231 IC has 19 memory registers, and these 19 memory registers do the functions of all time, date, alarm registers, temperature register and control and status register, which ultimately configures and sets up our RTC3231 module. Now how does this work is explained in the last video, that we first send the address of the DS3231 memory register in the data section. Okay, so in the data section we first send the address of the DS3231 memory register which we need to access, and then read and write bytes on those memory registers, on those locations, via I2C communication. Now when we are reading the data from the RTC3231 to get the time or the temperature details, we use our host microcontroller in master receiver mode, and RTC3231 is in slave transmitter mode. And we need to write data on the RTC3231 for configuring it, for setting its control and status register, for setting the alarm registers, or for setting the time. We use our host microcontroller in master transmitter mode, and RTC3231 is in slave receiver mode. Now we can divide the memory registers of the RTC3231 in 5 parts: time register, date register, configuring registers which are our control and status registers, temperature register which are the last two registers, and the alarm registers which sets our alarm at which we have to set alarm for the time of the alarm. Okay, and now all these time and date registers have contents in the form of binary coded decimal format. So when writing on these registers, we need to convert the decimal values which we need to set into the binary coded form. And when we are reading the data from these registers, we will get in the form of BCD. So we need to convert the BCD into the decimal format. Like in this program, I have created a two function specially for BCD to decimal conversion and decimal to binary coded conversion. When we are reading the time, so in that case, we will be getting the binary coded in the format from the RTC3231. So we need to convert that into decimal format. So we write like this, BCD to decimal function, and then data which we need to read. Okay. So now moving forward, we will first understand these memory registers. We will first understand the time and the date registers, and then the configuration registers, and then I will show you the further things. Now for the time, seconds, and the for like when we need to read time, we can directly read time starting from the address 00H. 00H represents the second, 01H represents the minute, and 02H represents the hour. Now in the seconds, we have the range from 00 to 59. Now we can divide this range 00 to 59 to two parts: 1 place of seconds and the tens place of seconds. Now, so for representing the ones place from 0 to 9 range, we can represent them in the binary form by the 4-bit numbers from 0 to 9 as shown in the figure. Similarly, for the tens place, so for ones place, we have bit 0 to bit 3. Same way for the tens place, we can represent it from 0 to 5. So 0 to 5 can be represented in 3-bit binary number. So bit 6, 5 and bit 4 are for tens place of the seconds. Same way for the minutes also. So 00H, 01H, 02H represent the time. But now when we don't want to read the time, we directly need to read the date, including the day of the week. We directly send the address of the day that is the 03H. Okay, so day register has address of 03H as you can see in the table, and now its range is from 1 to 7, and 1 to 7 is like 1 representing the our day, week, month, Monday, and 7th representing the Sunday. So we can represent 1 to 7 here by using the 0 to 6, and here 0 is being represented from 000 and 6 being represented as 110. So having the 3 bit binary number for its representation, so we have bit 0, 1 and 2 for our day of the week. Okay, same way for the date register, we have the 01 to 31 range. 1's place 0 to 9, 10's place have range from 0 to 3. So for 0 to 9, we need 4 bit binary numbers. So that's why we have first 4 bits for 1's place of the date, and the 10th place is being represented by 0 to 3. Okay, so 10th place of the month being represented as 0, 1, 2, 3, having the 2 bit binary number required. Okay, so does bit 5 and bit 4 of the day register, of the date register, represent the 10th place? Now for the month register, we have 0, 1 to 12. 01 being January and 12 being the December. So its 1's place is 1 to 9 being represented by the 4 bit binary number. And the 10's place is 0 or 1, which can be simply represented by a single bit, in which 0 bit means 0 and 1 bit means 1. So if, and now comes the year register. In the year register, we have 00 to 99. Now, because in this, like in a single century, we can have years from 00 to 99. So 09 being represented by first 4 bits, and then the last 4 bits and being are represented for the 10th place of the year. Okay, so that's it for the time and date registers that we need to understand. Now when writing our code, we just simply have to mention the address, and we need to operate the read or write operation. Like here, I have write functions. Okay, when we need to write date, so for writing the date, our address starts from 03H. So we simply first specify the write register, memory register of the write day 03, and then we simply keep on writing the date as location will be incremented automatically by 1. Same way for the write time, we need to mention, if we don't mention here write date as address, then also it works because by default it starts from 00. So we first mention the slave address, and then the, and we need to operate the write operation. Okay, then we simply write the date, seconds, minute and hour, and then the stop signal. So that's how we simply write the date and time. And when we need to read the date and time, so for that, what we do, we first mention down that at what address exactly we need to read. Okay, if we need to read date only, so we will first send the address 03H. So first we will write the address. Okay, write that I want to go to this location. So first sending the write address, slave address plus the write bit, then the write data so that it moves to the 03H, and then stop signal. Then again start the I2C session, send the start signal, and directly start reading the data from the location which we have mentioned in the previous write operation. So it will directly read the day, and then the day of the week, then day of the month and the year. And all this will be converted from BCD to decimal format. Okay, and same way for the write reading time, we don't have to mention address as our time starts from 00. So we will simply just write the BCD to decimal conversion and reading the time of seconds, minute and hour. So guys, now not taking the video too lengthy, for the description of the initializing registers and the temperature register of 3231 IC will be discussed in the next video. Till then, subscribe the channel. Press the notification bell to get notified for the next video, and do mention down your any views or queries in the comment section.